Masai Mara is one of the world's most famous wildlife destinations. And over the next couple of days, I'm going to be discovering what makes it so special right here at Karen Blixen Camp. This is my first time in the Masai Mara, and like most people who come this way, I'm hoping for those iconic wildlife encounters and a taste of the Masai culture. Karen Blixen Camp is in the Mara North Conservancy, which is an area of about 30,000 hectares located just north of the National Reserve. This is an exclusive part of the Mara. The land is owned by the local Masai people, and as well as limiting the number of guests, they permit experiences not possible in the main reserve. To get to the camp from Kenya's capital of Nairobi, it's either a 5-hour drive or a 1-hour flight. Flying can be an adventure in itself, and it's not unusual to stop at a couple of airstrips and even switch aircraft. Spotting wildlife from the sky is an exhilarating way to start the adventure, and this is generally the preferred method of transport. Upon landing at Mara North Airstrip, my guide Derek and guiding intern Wesley are both waiting for me. I'm quickly whisked away for a welcome drink, and then it's time for a game drive en route to check-in. The reason everyone loves it here is immediately evident. Animals are literally everywhere, and within minutes, I'm face to face with a pride of lions.
You hear the term bucket list a lot these days, but after a decade in the travel industry, I'm not sure I've been anywhere as bucket list worthy as the Masai Mara.
Karen Blixen Camp is comprised of 22 identical riverfront tents situated on raised timber platforms. They're spacious, well-furnished, spotlessly clean, with huge outdoor showers and large verandas to sit back and spot wildlife. Behind the tents is a tranquil pool and a day spa, while the common area and beating heart of the camp occupies prime real estate on the Mara River. This is where guests come for morning coffees, 3 a la carte meals a day, nightly fires, and everything in between. It's also the best spot for Karen Blixen's famed armchair safaris, and with a constant procession of animals, many find it hard to leave.
I think what the guests like most is the atmosphere, because we have a home setting up atmosphere. We try to do personalized service, and we treat our guests as individuals, not as a group.
The camp is unfenced, and while that might sound intimidating, Solomon assures me that even families with children can feel safe here.
All our guards are from the local Ma community, and they are the warriors who escort our guests to and from their tents. Over the years, we have never had any incident regarding safety of our guests.
The Masai community is integral to the Karen Blixen experience, and they work hand in hand with locals to ensure mutual benefits from tourism.
Over 70% of our staff are from the local community. We also pay monthly contribution to Mara North Conservancy, and this money is distributed to over 800 landowners. I think that has really played a role in making sure that they embrace conservation.
Karen Blixen market their property to a variety of travellers, including families and bird watchers, but it's also a great choice for the socially conscious. The camp runs off solar, recycles water, and has numerous initiatives like a catering school for Kenya's youth, tree planting projects, and more. You can learn all about this while here, but the priority for most travellers is to head out on safari. Game drives are usually conducted in the morning and the late afternoon, as this is considered the best time to spot wildlife. I'm told you see animals year-round here, including 4 of the big 5. However, peak season from June to September is when they're in greater abundance. This is also when the wildebeest migration is occurring. And while the Great Migration can make its way into the conservancy, to see this, or to see rhinos, it normally involves a full day trip to the main reserve. If you want that to be a part of your itinerary, make sure you give yourself more than the 48 hours I had, which limited me to the conservancy. Still, there's no shortage of things to do here.
Conservancy is an area that you can visit and you're allowed to do closer view of animals, like you can take off the road and get different angles of a different animal from, like, maybe you have the light into the camera, but in the conservancy you can turn around and go between the light and the camera. You have fantastic view of the particular animal. It's an area that you allow to do evening game drive and do night game drive. It's an area that you allow to stop out of your car, stretch your legs, walk around. It's an area where you can also do guided walking safaris. Whereas when you go to the national park, because of the population of people visiting those particular destinations, you have to stay more or less in the car.
Everything you need for a memorable trip is included in the rate at Karen Blixen. For those who want to add more wow factor, ballooning is a popular activity at an extra cost. Bush meals and sundowners are another optional extra, providing the opportunity to take these peaceful vistas in while enjoying a drink or a meal. While these provided memorable moments, it's the expert guides and getting up close to so many animals that really takes the cake.
What a special place the Mara North Conservancy is, and how fantastic it is to be away from the mass tourism that you might experience further south. If you're coming this way, I'd make sure you give yourself at least 3 nights. These animals are wild, you never know where or when they'll show up, and although it's teeming with wildlife, some species are easier to find than others. Karen Blixen Camp itself is a really comfortable property in a location that must be the envy of most other lodgers. Being along the river and watching the wildlife go by, you could spend days doing it. It really is a special place. What I love as much as anything is their genuine mission to try and help and empower the local community. Tourism has such an important role to play in preserving culture, wildlife, and this environment. And the initiatives that they've put in place really need to be commended. And in my view, it's as good a reason as any to support them. I hope you found this video a useful tool in understanding both Karen Blixen and what you can expect in this part of the world. If you'd like to see more like it, please tune in again soon. But until next time, my name is Ricky Dunn. Thanks for watching. Bye for now.